Well, hello from Tucson. We got some visitors again. We got Mojo Bus. This time, they actually came out so I could help them. If you see on the back of the bus there, there is a piece of sheet metal and a lot of banging going on. Update on the bus. It is, I'm still in the process of cleaning out the oil. I think it will be running right after we fix that. Also been waiting on some parts. I was away last weekend, meditating. It was nice. What else is going on? Still gotta work on this. Nothing's really changed since the last video. It's mostly been, oil and, I don't know, trying to figure out how to fix this thing. So, anyways, let's go say hello. That's part of the problem right there. Here's part of the other problem. Whoa, where'd your steps go, man?
They just fell out.
Also, good to see you again.
Absolutely good to see you.
In video, we've all obviously said hello in person. Are you guys putting in an elevator? What's going on?
Just a little lift.
Yeah. So, yeah. Do you want to walk us through what you're doing?
So, Chicago bus, my bottom step rotted out. Due to rust, the only thing that was holding on was some wood.
So this is what a rusty bus step looks like. I don't even know how this thing was actually held upright. Somebody took part of a rub rail and riveted or screwed it to the bottom. And then there's all, they reinforced it with wood. Long story short, they came back because I'm going to help them weld this thing and, you know, try and get the a step back in there. But they're also going to add a super cool feature, which you guys will see. The smile should say it all. I got the fuel level sender in completely blind, and all I got to do is hook it up now. So I'm super, super happy. All right, here's the progress today. Not a lot of filming. We're running around to the different stores and whatnot trying to get tools and grinders, but tomorrow I think we're gonna start welding. Is that right?
Hopefully.
Fingers are crossed.
Yeah, exactly. We're trying to figure out how to support this thing, because there's not a lot of anything except sheet metal down here, and so we're thinking a square, vertical, 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 and then of course all the sheet metal. All right, this is the following day. I'm gonna help out Mojo Bus in a second. But while they're cutting metal, I just wanna give you guys an update. The gene system is working. A bunch of the debris that didn't get caught by the strainer inside that filter, it's 168 micron. Way too big, right? Went through the denim genes, it's coming out super clear. So, just wanna give you guys a thumbs up on that. Also, you know what? I need to call the transmission guy, because he's been delaying me for several weeks. He's been a little busy. So I'm going to check in and see if we can get that in the shop at some point. Maybe next week. What are you doing down? Why the 45-degree angle?
Because this is going to be the bottom frame, the outside of the bottom frame.
Uh-huh.
So I need them to sit level and even, instead of sit on top of each other and bump everything up and make it all
in. And I told him it's easy, just as easy to cut a 45, just as easy to cut a 45 as a 90. Plus, it's real, looks sexy.
Even though it's going to be buried.
100% agree. And of course, he's using OSHA approved safety glasses for this cut.
My actor sunglasses.
We're doing welding 101. So we got metal, we have something to weld on top of so we don't ruin Glenn's nice concrete. We don't want to ruin your concrete. So I'm going to pass the camera over to Renee, and we're going to play with the welder here. So, oh, by the way, all the welders, feel free to correct me. There's definitely some things that I will be missing, but this is just the basics. All right, now remember, you're only as good as your teacher, and I am not that good at welding. I just know the basics, so here goes nothing.
Is that long enough?
It's a little on the long side, but if you want to, practice getting rid of the thing. So pull the trigger.
Pull the trigger and knock it on there?
Pull the trigger There you go, stop. Now put put it, you know, far close to the tip on the metal and just pop it real quick.
Like just touch it?
Yep. There you go. My proud student is learning how to weld, and it's looking pretty good so far. He's doing the outside edges of the bottom part so that the sheet metal will sit flat on the inside here.
Sounds about right.
How's it going so far, by the way?
I'm having fun.
How was I as a teacher? I know next to nothing about this stuff, but I know the basics.
Well, I mean, look at these welds. You must be a great teacher, huh?
Well, let's not get that far. But these are pretty damn good welds. This is literally his first time, so for all the welders out there, you'll probably agree that's a pretty clean weld. Now doing a dry fit. So Justin is, what are you doing?
This is where it's going to sit.
Cool.
So that'll work.
That's going to work? All right. So basically what they're going to do is clean up this whole thing, put some vertical pieces on it, and then we'll check back in at that point. But yeah, thanks. These guys are making me some lunch right now. I just sawzalled this off. That was kind of fun. All right, here we go. Here is a mock-up. This is, I know the lighting is such that it's a little hard to see, but there's nothing really we can do about it. There we go. That's a good shot. It is just anchored in by gravity.
Pressure.
These were a pain in the ass to get off. I had to use some kind of torch to torch the bolts off, and then an air tool to extract the bolts and all that fun stuff. That's where this thing sits, so those are fun to get off. We're just kind of analyzing the design here, and otherwise, you know, it's coming right along here.